Good day, motivators. My name is Sergeant Lafferty. Today we're going to be conducting a pre-op on an ESD mat. When dealing with SRAs and WRAs, we have to be conscious of electrostatic discharge. ESD is something to be aware of no matter what type model series aircraft you work with or around. The simplified description of ESD breaks down to the transfer of an electronic charge from a greater potential to a lesser potential, in accordance with the NAMP
4790.2 Delta,
Chapter 10, Paragraph
10.21.3.1.
All electronic weapons replaceable assemblies, shop replaceable assemblies, and electronic components will be considered ESDS. ESD sensitive gear will be worked on in conjunction with ESD mats in order to ensure the longevity of our aircraft equipment. During this video, we will go through the process of ensuring our ESD portable field service kit is in good working condition by performing the required pre-operational checklist in accordance with 17-TAC-600-TAC-193 ESD-TAC-6-TAC-1. Step 1. Locate NAVAIR publication 17-TAC-600-TAC-193 ESD-TAC-6-TAC-1, which is our pre-operational checklist for ESD protection devices. Use what is available, whether that be paper publication or PIMA. Step 2. Check out ESD portable field service kit, a multimeter, two leads, and verify the multimeter and leads work properly by testing for continuity. You can do this verification by placing multimeter to read for ohms and putting both lead tips together. If multimeter reads continuity, they are good to be used for your pre-operational checkout procedure. Step 3. Refer to publication 17-TAC-600-TAC-193 ESD-TAC-6-TAC-1 to begin static inspection found on page 1. Note that since we are using a portable ESD mat, that it is considered to be a single conductor ESD mat. Since that is the case, we will only be following paragraphs 2 through 6, as paragraph 7 onwards is for 2M stations located in either intermediate or depot level maintenance activities. The first step in the static inspection is to inspect wrist straps and cords for cracked insulation, exposed wires, bent pins, tears, corrosion, cleanliness, etc. Make sure to take your time and cover every portion of the wrist straps and cords. This should not be a quick inspection, but a thorough one. Replace any units with cracked insulation, exposed wiring, or frayed fabric if using cloth material. Paragraph 3. Inspect ESD mat for material condition, corrosion, and cleanliness. Again, this should be a thorough inspection looking for any defects in the material of the mat. Replace any mat with any physical damage. If cleaning is required, use a damp cloth and ensure mat is dry before use. For 2M and all rigid mats, clean in accordance with NAVAIR 17-TAC-600-TAC-193-TAC-6-TAC-2. Note, 2M and rigid mats are typically located in either intermediate or depot level maintenance activities. Paragraph 4. Install single conductor ESD mat cord system. For wrist strap only or ESD mat with wrist strap use on aircraft, connect wrist strap or ground cord to aircraft structure. Since we are using a field kit, we'll be attaching the wrist strap to the ESD mat, and then the alligator clip will connect to the aircraft structure, like so. If an earth ground checker with NAVAIR 17-TAC-600-TAC-193 ESD-TAC-6-TAC-1 wrist strap jack is used, verify that the device indicates good ground by consulting the device legend. If the EGC fails, then use it on another AC outlet. If the device still does not indicate correctly, replace EGC. Caution: do not connect ESD grounds directly to AC outlet ground wire. Failure to follow instructions could result in damage or destruction to other equipment. The proper use of an EGC does not constitute hooking directly to the AC outlet ground wire. Paragraph 5. Using a multimeter, measure from hard ground the set screw of the banana plug of an EGC configuration or aircraft structure to metal portion of wristband that contacts skin. As stated, the places you measure will change depending on the setup you are currently using. Today we are testing from hard ground to the metal portion of our wrist strap. Multimeter should indicate a minimum of 0.8 megaohms to a maximum of 1.2 megaohms. Replace any unit that does not meet minimum / maximum resistance to hard ground. Paragraph 6. Using multimeter, measure from hard ground the set screw of the banana plug in an EGC configuration or aircraft structure to the utilized metal snap on the mat. So we will measure from the snap to the aircraft structure. Multimeter should indicate a minimum of 0.8 mega ohms to a maximum of 1.2 mega ohms. Replace any unit that does not meet minimum slash maximum resistance to hard ground. Note, the reading in step 6 above may be taken from the undersized of the utilized snap on the mat if the snap has exposed metal. Otherwise, the reading should be taken between the junction block and the snap it utilizes. Some mats provide a second snap on the mat for ease of access. Do not use this utilized snap during step 6. This concludes our ESD pre-operational checklist. The mat is good to be used in this setup for up to 24 hours. If you change the arrangement by moving the wrist strap to a different snap point on the ESD mat, or the alligator clip is attached to the aircraft structure or hard ground, you must verify the meter readings once again before utilizing the ESD mat. Remember that all maintenance must be done in accordance with the NAMP and applicable publications. Have a good day, motivators. Semper Fi.